Well, welcome back to a new video, guys. It is a frosty one. So I'm going to be out today doing a spot of dead baiting. Now the river is up, as you can see behind me, it's quite up. So I'm going to be targeting quite a few slacks if and when I can find them. I'm going to start, as I say, just fishing a basic double SSG with three double SSGs above the trace and a roach dead bait. I've got a couple of different sized roach dead baits. I've got a large roach and then medium as well, and some smaller ones. So very simple setup. Try a few swims. I've got a seat with me as well if I want to stop off and have a little breather. And yeah, I think it's going to be a case of really looking into those slacks and seeing if we can get a take from a pike in any of those where they might be laying up in the current flow that we've got going on here, because currently, a lot of currents there, currently it is quite up, and it's creating a few nice eddies on some of the section of river. So that's the sum of it. Dead baiting, different rod to last time. This particular one is the Black Rock 9 foot. This is a power action though rod. This is a 2 pound test curve. I thought as the river might be up, it might be a wise choice. But yeah, as I said on my previous videos for my barbel rod, they do them in all shapes and sizes and different test curves. Got this one for actually for doing a bit of carp fishing, but I also thought it would double up nicely as a kind of like nice little pike rod as well. And it's not too long, 9 foot, nice length to still get into some spots, but also have a little bit extra control. Kingfisher has just absolutely gunned past me. I don't know if you heard it there and saw it, it's just off camera, shot past, bolt of blue. Always look at that as a good omen, but it's a good omen just to be out and fishing once again. So that's the sum of it. Dead bait rod, try quite a few swims, roach dead baits. No more waffle, let's get cracking and let's see if we can pick up a pike or two. Thank you. cracking. I just thought I'd twitch it a little bit and draw it back into the margins there. Lovely take. Beautiful, beautiful take there, just as I brought the dead bait in a little bit closer. I thought I'd try a little bit of sink and draw there. And yeah, what a take. Come up to the surface and grabbed it, went back down. Beautiful fish. Absolutely corking. Very happy with this. Visibility isn't that great on the river. The actual water clarity is quite poor. This one on one side looks like he's had a lucky escape from a otter, I think. But yeah, what a cracking take. Anyway, let's get it slipped back. One look at the head of this croc. Oh yes, what a beauty. Absolute corker. Pull myself back. There we go. Cracking way to start the trip. Happy days. Thank you. Right, the death, guys, we're in. There we go. £10.07 of beautiful, hard fighting river esooks. A set of gnashers. I've done it a favour as well. It had someone's size 10 hair rig, which obviously picked up their lunch and meat or boilie. And so I got that out as well. So it being caught has done it a favour. Anyway, let's get this lovely fish slipped back. Well, there you go. Never give up the ghost, you just got to keep on keeping on, or so goes the lyrics of one of my favourite songs. But yeah, real nice to get that fish at the death. I thought I'd cook the goose, sprung the hatch, you know. I thought I'd had my chances. That's why I went off to the other swims, tried those other little tight nooky cranny slack area where there's quite a bit of tree cover, because I thought I'd rest this spot, then come back to it and see if there was any pike in those spots. And they look real good skulking zones. I mean, nice slack, good depth. But yeah, come back to this spot, had my final cast, rain started to come down a little bit more, and then stop, then shower again, and ease off, and then shower. And yeah, I was just getting ready. I was alternating the casts. I'd had three casts in total before I packed up. One to my left, one straight out, one to my right. I was kind of like fan casting in the way and leaving it for a little while. And then as I was bringing it in, just bobbing it slightly. But the last cast, I put it down my right hand margin where I had earlier on in the trip, I had one knock there. It went boom, and that was it. I didn't get any other bites, and I thought, got to give it another go, just on that right-hand margin. Nice little drop-off there, lovely little weed patch as well, so I thought it would be, you know, decent, and maybe something was still lurking there. And sure enough, just as I went to wind in, I could feel just that little bit of resistance, and I just felt slight movement, like something had just sat there, literally on the bait, without even showing the slightest line movement at the front of the line, or even the rod tip moving. So I just wound down and just thought, I bet there's a fish just sat on this bait. Bang, struck it, and yeah, the rest is history. Lovely scrap, lovely looking pike. Whether that was the one that I'd lost earlier, could well have been, I don't know for sure, but that fish I did lose earlier, where you saw me go nuts on camera, yeah, that was a double. So and this fish was 10-7, so could well have been the same fish, but did it a favour, had a another hook in it with a hair rig, so a little bit of surgery there, and got that one out as well. Got good raking on the from the pike, and got a nice sore and profusely bleeding cut on the back of my hand. It's always a sign of a decent trip though, isn't it? You know, it's a mark of honour as such as a pike angler. But yeah, very happy with those two doubles. Of course it would have been nice to have had all three, presuming that last fish wasn't the fish that I lost earlier on. And it would have been nice to have some more fish from the other swims as we made our way through the river. But you know, the river is up, it's pushing through, and you know, if you'd asked me would I take one fish at the start and by the end, then yes. If you'd asked me if would I taken one fish though by the end, having lost that other fish, I probably would have, but I was quite gutted, as you could see. So yeah, nice to have that fish. Anyway, it's been a pleasure as always to bring you the video, another video, and it's always great to have your support, guys. I really do mean that. I had a bit of a down time, a little slope with my emotional side going off kilter recently, as some of you who follow me, well, many of you who follow me on Instagram will know, regarding another channel that was hopping into places and being led and given information by someone else on social media, and that really did take me for a turn for the worse, and I would have nearly closed down the channel. I'm deadly serious, and many of you know that I was thinking about doing that, and it's you guys that really, you know, got in touch with me and say, don't do that, don't let the bastards get you down, kind of thing. And yeah, you've really spurred me on, and I am on this run of doing regular videos, and it's thanks to you. You know, you lift me up, and as I know that some of you who watch my videos, when you can't get out, it lifts you up. So yeah, we're in this for the long run, we're in it together, and it's great to have your guys' support and your viewership, your comments. I really do wholeheartedly love making the videos, love hearing from you guys. Yeah, it's wonderful. So I'm blabbering, I'm waffling. Thanks for watching the video. And wherever you're wetting a line, wherever you're dangling your end tackle, I hope you're getting a fair crack of the whip. Catch you on the flip side on another Fishing for Memories video. Take care.